Hello and welcome. In this video we're going to evaluate the integral of 1 over 9 plus x squared from a lower limit of x equals 0 to a higher limit of x equals 3. A definite integral, we're going to find an actual number or a value rather than an expression, as in the case of an indefinite integral. Alright, the first thing we got to check before we do the integral is to make sure that the expression that we're integrating is continuous over the domain from x equals 0 to x equals 3. In this case it is. However, if we had a discontinuous function over that domain, then we wouldn't be able to evaluate such an integral, because the fundamental law of calculus states that we can only integrate from the lower limit to the upper limit if the function is continuous. And if you don't understand that, I'll explain that in future videos. But for now, everything is okay, so let's go ahead. I'm going to rewrite this integral a little bit. So I'm going to go from 0 to 3. I'm going to integrate from 0 to 3 of 1 over 3 squared. And so instead of writing 9, I'm going to write 3 squared plus x squared dx. Now that we've got an expression we can find the antiderivative of. And from my last video, we found that the integral of 1 over a squared plus x squared is equal to 1 over a multiplied by the inverse tan of x divided by a. So corner that off a little bit. So include a link to my last video on how I came up with this answer. So all we need to do now is to write down 1 over 3 times the inverse tan of x divided by 3. Now when we do definite integrals, we don't need to include the plus c, because the c integration constant will cancel out when we evaluate the integral anyway. But we still need to include the upper and lower limits. So the expression that we end up with is 1 over 3 times inverse tan of x on 3 bounded by the upper lower limits of 3 and 0. And to evaluate that, we just substitute 3 for x minus the expression with 0 for x. So 1 over 3 tan, sorry, inverse tan of 3 divided by 3 minus 1 over minus 1 third times inverse tan of 0 over 3. Well, I'm going to use a little bit of my knowledge on trigonometry to help me evaluate this instead of plugging these values into a calculator. It's always good to put your knowledge into practice. Know that the tan of my angle is going to be the opposite side divided by the adjacent side. So tan theta is equal to opposite over the adjacent. So the angle is going to be the inverse tan of opposite over the adjacent. I'll just corner this off as well. So in evaluating the inverse tan of 3 over 3, the adjacent side and the opposite side are equal to each other, so therefore the angle must be 45 degrees, or 45 degrees is equal to pi on 4 minus 1 third. What we have here is the opposite side length being 0 and the adjacent side length being 3. So therefore that means we have a horizontal line. So the angle of a horizontal line will be 0. So tan of 0 is equal to 0. So that means our final answer for this integral is equal to pi over 12. Alright, so on a side note, it's always a good idea to remember that inverse tan of 1 is equal to pi on 4, and the inverse tan of 0 is equal to 0. I hope you now better understand the concept of definite integrals. Please give me a thumbs up if you have found this video helpful. If you are a math student, please feel free to subscribe for future videos that may help you on assignments or exams. If you have any question that you would like me to do a video on, please feel free to comment on any of the videos that you've seen. Thanks for watching, and I hope you learned something.